All right, it took some time, but certainly Erik Karlsson looks like he's fit in just fine out there in San Jose. And it really playing up to the hometown crowd there at the All-Star game. You were out there. What did you take away from it?
You know, just by chance, I ran into Erik after the game at a local pizza joint. And he was very relaxed. He was excited about being there. He was looking forward to going on hopefully a long playoff run with San Jose. But I was really impressed with his demeanor. He absolutely loves playing in San Jose. I didn't ask him, obviously, what's going to happen long term. The big question everybody wants to know. But for right now, he loves being out there in San Jose.
What does Erik Karlsson order on a pizza? That's what I want to know. You can tell a lot from toppings.
The thing that will shock you is that Erik Karlsson is a distinctive-looking person, obviously, with the long hair and the goatee. Looks like he could be something, a character right out of Game of Thrones. Not that recognized, though, there. Very shocked. Now, where we were, people wouldn't expect him, but he had a pair of shorts on. He was very casual. The ownership knew who he was, obviously, of the restaurant, but he's probably enjoying some anonymity coming from Ottawa.
Well, there's 31 teams in the league that certainly know who he is when he's on the ice, and he's a pending UFA coming up on July 1. What do you think the future holds for Erik Karlsson, Billy, now that he's kind of settled in out there in San Jose?
For now, it's all about San Jose. You don't hear the team talking about a contract. You don't hear Karlsson talking about a contract. They want to move forward. They want to try and win a Stanley Cup. That is where the agenda is. In the summer, if they get far in the Stanley Cup or make a big playoff run, then Erik Karlsson probably would like to stay there. He's fit in very nicely. He's a very big key cog on that team. But what I like about it is it's all about now. It's in the moment. We're going to focus on the task at hand. The defenseman, where do we go from here? Him and Brent Burns are starting to finally click. They have a legitimate chance to advance and maybe go all the way to the Stanley Cup and win it. So it's all in, chips on the table, see where they fall. Erik Karlsson will decide after that. And I like Karlsson too. He's invested in it, the whole team. So the right direction, it's just day by day, one step at a time. And when the season ends and everything blows out, that's when the decisions will be made.
So how is this one different than the situation that we have in Columbus with the tweet from Panarin's agent, other than the tweet is out there? How are those scenarios different in this aspect?
In some ways, they're not completely different. Obviously, San Jose would love to sign him. We saw some impending UFAs there on the board, though. A guy like Joe Pavelski, obviously, Joe Thornton. Don't know what's going to happen with him, but he's certainly, both those players are playing excellent right now for San Jose. Their games are picking up. But in the end, he could just be a rental in San Jose. And I think Doug Wilson's okay with that. I think he knew that when he made the deal. I think he feels like he paid maybe just a little bit of a discount of what you would have had to pay if you knew you were going to keep him. And that's the arbitrage right there when you make a deal like that. If they go on and make it to the Stanley Cup Finals and Erik Karlsson is gone, then I will tell you, Billy, they will be still 100% satisfied that they made that trade. And they're really close, San Jose. They look excellent. But what really doesn't get counted, in my opinion, for a guy like Erik Karlsson, whose scoring is now there, is the job that he's doing in making some of their forwards look even better. A guy like Joe Pavelski. These guys are playing virtually no time in their own end. The puck is in the zone, and those guys get it up and out, and it allows their offensive players to do what they're due. And that's why I think we're seeing a lot of guys explode on that team as well this season.
That's what I like about San Jose, too. Pavelski, Thornton, you're not hearing anything out of
anything.
Them.
Anything. No, and they have a ton of UFAs.
This could be a problem. This is how San Jose handled things. I had a chance to play in San Jose briefly. It's a first-class organization, and Doug Wilson, they're doing a tremendous job. But it's all about this year.
Yeah, and I think everybody's content with that.